I grew up in this town that's about 20 miles up the road from Charlotte called Davidson, and it's a small college town. And it was a pretty cool place to grow up because it's just like one little town, and then all around it, it's like all this farmland that's actually getting all screwed up now. And when I was growing up, it was just like you went about 1 mile out the road on your bike or in a car, and you'd be out in the country, and there'd be all these little roads that go like this all through everywhere, and the cows and barbed wire fences and stuff. And so as a teenager, this is the impetus for like one of our songs on Galaxy 500 called Riding Around. We used to like, we'd get the car, one of us would have the car, Dad's car, and all the rest of us would pile in it. We'd get like as much beer as $4 would buy, which was pretty much then, I guess, and like pretzels or something. And we'd just go driving around like crazy with like Aerosmith or Zeppelin like blaring out of the car and getting drunk, drunk driving. I approve. But we never did get in any trouble. It was just kind of like, you know, you're too young to go to a bar and your parents won't let you drink at home. And if you sat around out in town, the police would come by and pick you up. So being out in the country in a car was your only safe place to like get off and be wild. And then that song Chicken Truck that's on Galaxy 500, that song is, well, that's really more like a kind of interstate kind of song, because, or a kind of Highway 64 going from Charlotte to Raleigh kind of song, because it's the kind of highways that that those chicken trucks, like going from Holly Farms up to the Kentucky Fried Chicken warehouse, they drive these chicken trucks with all the poor little chickens in cages about this big, like five of them, and it's really sad. And that's actually like kind of a sad song, even though people don't know it.
I didn't really make a real conscious decision that I wanted to be in a band until shortly before I ended up being in one. But I think I always, deep down inside, wanted to be involved in music. But I never really thought I could. I knew I couldn't learn to play the guitar or anything really hard like that. And I've always been a big mouth, so I guess singing was what seemed the most obvious and most natural. But I thought that you really had to have like a lot of singing lessons and be in the choir and in the church choir and everything to be in a band. And so I would just sing along with all my favorite records and try to sing just like Bonnie Raitt or Joan Armatrading or Todd Rundgren or Patti Smith or somebody. And then when the punk movement came along and it was in full steam, I was in the middle of being in school, and slowly I realized that people that I knew that weren't really very much musical experts at all were being in bands. And so I said, hell, I can do that too.
I suppose what makes Fetchin Bones special is that the emphasis is on having fun. When we perform, you know, all the main goal is for everybody to have a good time, the crowd and the band, and it's not look at us, we're the world's greatest musicians, because we're not, and you know, it's not, you know, everybody come out and make the scene and see how cool you can be. I think everybody's really there. People like to dance, which is something people don't like to do to live music very much anymore. And just really have a good time. And I think that, you know, the band is friendly, tries to be friendly to the crowd, and I think that people appreciate that. We'll be right back.
mostly, lyrically, I try not to be too specific politically in the songs, but certain themes keep reoccurring, and it's things that I'm really concerned about. A song like Kingdom on Galaxy 500, or a new song that we wrote, Sons of the Dinosaurs, or another new song, Bonework. It's basically the same kind of theme, and it's when I look around and I see, like, the destruction of the entire environment of the entire Earth, slowly but surely, and I think, well, why is it happening, and why don't any of the politicians, Republican or Democrat, care about it? And then I start to go, oh, God, it's because, you know, big money, big businesses actually run all the governments of the nation, and the banks, Citibank and every evil bank in the world actually, you know, is running the world's economies, not and the world's governments. And then I go, oh, no, no, you know, no wonder the whales are dying. No wonder we're not going to have any ozone left, and we're all going to die of skin cancer, you know. And then I think, boy, I'm such a positive up person. But that's why I try to write songs about it. And I try not to be, like, literally, like, this is what's the matter, and this is why, and point fingers in every direction. Because it's any kind of revolution, it probably needs to start at home. It's not like blowing up all the banks or all the governments in the world. It's more like examining your personal lifestyle and the things that surround you. Examine how you spend money and what you need to live, and like trying to be more responsible in your purchases and in your lifestyle, and slowly affect a revolution through each person, so that there would slowly be no demand for the things that are evil and that are environmentally destructive.